outside is frightful, yet the fire is so delightful, and since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping, and I brought me some coffee popping. The lights are turned way down low, let it snow, let it snow.
Even coming if I should lay out some cookies and milk for him. Let's check him out after finishing dishes. Alright, let's see what those crazy elves are up. What the? Oh no, not again! Looks like there's a whole trail of them. At least they left me room to get up this time. Let's see where it leads to, shall we? I bet it leads to the Christmas tree again. Yep, what do you know? Look, Danny and Elfie are sitting right under it. I mean, Danny and Rosie. Did I say Danny and Elfie? I meant Danny and Rosie. And it looks like they put some candy canes on the Christmas tree. Well, thank you guys. That was mighty generous of you. Well, if you'll excuse me, I'll go back to my...
Hey, Rosie, guess what?
What?
It's time to wash the dishes again.
Okay.
Again, I'll wash and you dry.
Sounds good.
What are you guys doing? Oh, I see. You're washing the dishes. And you're trying to dry them, aren't you? Well, thank you, guys. You did it again. Danny, Rosie, you guys are in the tissue box again? And Danny, you look like you're in a pool or something, like you're just chilling. And Rosie, you still look like you're dead or something. I don't know. It's weird. Oh, well. Alright, time to see what those crazy elves are up to. What the... Danny, Rosie, did you unravel the toilet paper again? They sure enough did. Ay, ay, ay. Breakfast. What the? Are those Danny's legs in the cereal bag? I think it is. Yep, there he is. He's in the cereal bag. Well, I'm not allowed to touch him, but looks like he got into the waffle crunch. Danny, you naughty little elf. Naughty, naughty, naughty.
Get it from the coffee bag, stubborn in the long run. I'm a way,
Danny, you did it again! And you used Jack's lipstick again! is an 8. Alright, let's get started then.
Alright.
No peeky!
Hey, Ruthie, guess what? We're supposed to read The Night Before Christmas.
Yeah, but we still don't have it.
Okay, so let's read another book. The Curious Little Kitten's First Christmas. It was the night before Christmas. Everyone in the house was asleep, except a curious little kitten. She was wide awake and full of curiosity.
She was curious about the stockings hanging by the fireplace. She had seen stockings before, of course. She had seen them in drawers and on people's feet, but never by the fireplace.
She was also curious, about the big tree in the living room. She had seen trees before, of course. She had seen them in the park and in the yard, but never in the living room and never full of colorful balls and paper chains. On the ledge besides the fireplace was a gingerbread house. This made the little kitten more curious than ever.
She had seen houses before. She had seen them made of bricks and logs, but she had never seen a little house which smelled this good. Who could live inside such a house? The curious little kitten decided to wait to see who would come out of the sweet-smelling door.
But even though the little kitten tried and tried to stay awake, she fell asleep. She slept for a long, long time. And look, Santa came while the kitten was sleeping.
When the little kitten woke up, it was Christmas morning. She wondered and wondered. Who put the presents under the tree? Was the curious little kitten still curious? Of course, and look, the little kitten's looking at the tree like, what the heck? And look, we're watching a little Yule log thing.
Oh, my sheep's in the bag. Hang on, let me move the bag out of your way, Pete. There we go.
Well, that was fun. Let's do it again next year.
I agree.
Goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye. All right, time to see where those elves are. Look, they're under the tree, and what's that note say? Let me see that. It says, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas to you guys, too, and thanks for all the adventures. I really grew fond of you guys.